Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're doing our second discussion on upper and lower bounds and doing some worded problems. Now before we begin on the worded problems, just linking back to what we've previously done on Hegarty Maths, you've been able to identify and work out the upper and lower bounds of any numbers that have been rounded. Pause the video and check you can find the upper and lower bounds of these three numbers given that they've been rounded as told in the brackets. Okay, the technique I showed you to do that is look at what we've been rounding to, the nearest 10, half that number, and we are going to subtract it from our number 650 to get the lower bound, so we have 645. We're going to add it on to get the upper bound, 655. Now we put a square bracket around the 645 because we want that included as a lower bound, as a number that would round to 650, but we write a curly bracket around the 655 to show that really we mean 654.99999 recurring. Okay, right, let's keep going. This has been rounded to 2SF. The second significant figure is the hundreds column, so it's been rounded to nearest 100, half that to get 50, and we're going to subtract it to get 5550 for the lower bound and add it on to get 5650 to get the upper bound, like that. And the last one, this has been rounded to 1dp, that's the nearest tenth. We'll half that to get 0.05, and we're going to subtract that for the lower bound, 0.35, and add it on, 0.45, for the upper bound. And that's the skill we need for this video to apply to our worded problems. So let's try them. In the DIY store, the height of a desk is 125 centimetres to the nearest centimetre. State the upper and lower bound for the height of the desk. Well, we've been told that it's been measured to the nearest centimetre, i.e. the nearest 1 centimetre. We half that to get 0.5 centimetres. We're going to subtract it from our amount to get the lower bound and add it to our amount to get the upper bound. So our bounds are going to be like this. We're going to subtract that and get 124.5 centimetres for the lower bound and 125.5 centimetres for the upper bound. There you go, done. Next example. Colin weighs himself as 93 kilograms to the nearest kilogram. What is the least he could possibly weigh? The least he could possibly weigh, they're asking us here for the lower bound, right? So all we have to do is work out the lower bound. Now we've been told it's been measured to the nearest kilogram, that's 1 kilogram. We half that to get 0.5 kilograms, subtract it for the lower bound, add it for the upper bound. So the lower bound is going to be 92.5 kilograms, the upper bound is going to be 93.5 kilograms with a curly bracket. They asked us for the least he could weigh, so state it at the end, least Colin could weigh is 92.5 kilograms, and we're done. Next question. Brian measures his height as 190 centimeters to the nearest centimeter. What is the tallest Brian could be? They're asking here for the upper bound for Brian's height, the upper bound. Now Brian's measured himself to the nearest 10 centimeters, so we half that and get 5 centimeters. Add that on for the upper bound, subtract that for the lower bound. The lower bound, therefore, is 185 centimetres. The upper bound will be 195 centimetres. Now, they asked the tallest Brian could be, so we should finish with the sentence, the tallest Brian could be is. Now, really, by this, we mean 194.49 recurring centimetres, but you may get away within the exam writing 195 centimetres, as that technically is what's called the upper bound. So either of these should do for you. Have a go. Pause and have a go. So the length of a runway is 2,800 metres to the nearest 100 metres. So we're going to half that and get 50 metres. Now they asked us the minimum length that the runway could be, i.e. they're asking us the lower bound, right? So we'll just do our normal, we'll subtract to get the lower bound, it would be 2,750, add to get the upper bound 2850 with curly brackets like that. And let's just state our final answer, therefore the minimum length would be the lower bound, which is 2750. Don't forget your units, meters. And we're done. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching.